Hey YouTube, what's up? Today it's Creative Vlog and the big comeback of food photography, and also a lot of challenges with the Photoshop. You'll see, pretty homemade. Remember the last time we talked about food photography? I was still in Melbourne. Oh, I miss this city so much. But it's been several months since I'm back in Lyon, my hometown, which is not only the place where cinema was born, but which has been the world capital of gastronomy for just, what, 2,000 years? It's because of its position as a central crossroads in Europe under the Roman Empire, then the great fairs during the Renaissance, the first mothers, La Mère Guy, La Mère Brigousse, obviously La Mère Brasier, and the world-renowned chefs such as Paul Bocuse and Christian Pédois. In short, food is a serious matter here. Plot twist, I'm not the one taking pictures today. Mathilda is going to work. I decided to call on a real food photographer, and yeah, she's crazy talented. And since I'm not committed to anything, because I don't shoot, I took the opportunity to challenge her. No studio, no nice professional lighting, no extraordinary food from a restaurant with a magnificent decoration. No, the conditions of anyone who will not be a professional or who will not have the chance to live in a city where the cuisine shines worldwide, you know? We're going to go to the first convenience store in the area and we are going to try to find some really cheap food. You know what you eat when you're a student and you don't have any money? Stuff that usually tastes like the packaging cardboard. Let's go.
The goal will obviously be to find elements that are already prepared, therefore easy to stage and that remain visually interesting.
Si je vais mettre après une petite plante, des petites épices sur le dessus. Mm-hmm. Je veux avoir des petits cakes comme ça. Après, des petits trucs apéro. Ça fonctionne, hein? De quoi on part? Légumes ou jambon olive? On se la joue végétarien. Après, les petites bouffes aussi, elles sont sympas. Les gaufres, ça peut être assez kiki aussi. Après.
First step, the staging. Obviously, we're going to try to stick with the minimum. We can't really rely on food to add visual accessorization elements, since we have to use only what we took from the grocery store. We'll rather try to play with the table utensils.
Ok, voilà. Ça peut être stylé pour mettre la soupe dedans.
I know we said minimal, but you're not going to tell me you don't at least have plate and cutlery.
Globalement, tout ce qui est brocante ou grenier de grand-mère, il y a beaucoup de choses intéressantes. Faut juste commencer par savoir sur quel style on veut partir en fait. Soit on part sur du plus moderne, soit on veut partir sur des trucs plus vintage, avec des plus vieux trucs. La première chose à choisir finalement, c'est les accessoires.
Between modern style and more vintage, we decided to go for the second one. We're going to try a rather rustic universe for our first shoot, with this beautiful warm wood of the coffee table that will serve as a background, and the delicious granny's traditional soup.
Good.
That is fucking disgusting.
We're going to give it a homemade aspect with just a little pepper and some basil leaves. And bim, look at that. Is it not magnificent?
Ça passe.
Lovely.
Before we start the light setup, we'll first think about framing, since we'll organize the light based on the composition afterward.
Je vais juste regarder d'un point de vue cadrage de quel côté je vais me mettre quand même, parce que c'est ça qui va déterminer où je vais mettre ma lumière. Là, on a un truc assez sympa. Non, c'est pas logique. Là, je voulais la cadrer en fait comme ça. Donc c'est plus joli si on a la hanse. Mais le problème, c'est que si je mets là, je mets la cuillère de ce côté. Et je trouve ça pas logique d'avoir la cuillère du côté où t'attrapes en fait le bol. Du coup, pour moi, ça ne fonctionne pas.
Okay, I know what you're thinking. We're pretty far in the nitpicking mindset. Well, no, it's just the opposite. It's that level of obsession that makes her a pro. Tell you one thing. Today, anyone can take a nice picture. It's not so complicated. Making a beautiful picture is not anymore a point of differentiation with other photographers. But to put this level of reflection in every detail of a picture and thus give it a meaning, to be able to add a message to it, that's rare. If you've ever seen one of my videos, you already know what I'm about to say. The most important thing is, what does it tell? Getting your brain used to this kind of interrogation when you build your image is what will make you become a professional, not technical skills like knowing which shutter speed to use for each situation, for example. Yeah, it's a complex topic. We'll talk about it one day, because obviously it doesn't only apply to food photography.
You know my love for natural light, but today we're going to do without it. First of all, it's not really possible in Matilda's apartment, and it will also allow me to show you that you don't need to invest thousands of dollars in studio lights to get a proper result. Here we will use a simple light ring for selfie, or a little LED lamp, or even a simple bedside lamp. Well, yeah, I told you we were doing homemade today.
Une petite ambiance, et donc pourquoi il faut surélever? C'est que là, la lumière, si elle est trop basse, bah en fait, ça éclaire pas la soupe. Donc si on la met déjà plus haut... Oh, c'est moche. Dites pas ça, c'est moche! Je pense qu'on peut ajuster parce qu'on a trop de lumière ici et on n'en a pas assez ici.
The most important thing is to find ways to diffuse the light. So how do you do it?
Le matériel du professionnel de la débrouille, c'est le papier cuisson et le papier d'aluminium. Ça sauve des vies, ça! On a des ombres qui viennent un peu perturber l'image. Donc là, l'idée, c'est de venir tamiser en fait la lumière.
And bim, diffuse light, no, that's better. Hey, I realized we didn't talk about gear and I feel like you're gonna be mad at me if I don't. Matilda is in Team Canon with the 5D Mark III, a camera that is a bit old, and actually not really, but still a beast. We also made some tests just with our phones, and we must admit that we easily reach a great result, especially with flat lay, where the depth of field must be at the maximum. Forget the bokeh here, the important thing is the level of detail in the image.
Mais Matilda, comment je fais moi si chez moi ça ressemble à rien? Que ma table elle est pas belle, que j'ai pas des beaux meubles, que j'ai pas des beaux murs, que j'ai pas un beau décor. Du coup, dans ce cas de figure, j'aime me monter un petit studio à domicile, fait maison. Voilà, voilà par exemple, j'ai du fond béton, j'ai du fond bois clair, j'ai du fond béton blanc.
In the description, you will find links for most of the accessories we use today. For the vinyl backgrounds, Matilda orders them from a French creator, but she ships only in Europe. So I will try to find some worldwide dealers if you're interested to buy some.
A table, a wall, a few pieces of duct tape, and here we have a photo background that will do the trick at a lower cost. We're going to stay in our rustic style and choose this nice white wood there for our second shoot with this beautiful cake that looks really delicious.
Oh, c'est très joli. La déception est intense.
Once again, the steps will be the same. First, think about the framing, then position the lights accordingly, and finally diffuse them to have soft shadows.
Ah ben on est beaucoup mieux. Ça c'était donc sans le papier cuisson, et après ajout du papier cuisson. Pour moi, ce qui me semble primordial, c'est que là, il faut régler absolument la balance des blancs.
When you shoot in RAW, the white balance is obviously editable in post-prod. But on this kind of photoshoot tent specifically, where this kind of light sources are, either too warm or too cold, take the time to customize it when you shoot. First, because saying, okay, we'll fix that in post, is the never most intelligent thing to say, think or do.
Moi, je l'ai fait de manière à avoir une lumière blanche, en fait, qui paraisse naturelle. Hop. Voilà, on arrive vite à ce genre de résultat en fait.
And when the white balance goes too much in the extremes, fixing it during the editing always generates a more or less subtle color alteration, so you might as well avoid it. We talked about the camera, but did we talk about lenses?
J'avais un 24-70. Là, je suis passée au 100 mm, plus tu prends un grand angle et plus tu vas avoir de la déformation et des perspectives en fait, sur ton image. Plus tu vas focus avec un téléobjectif et plus tu seras focus sur le produit. Là, du coup, pourquoi j'ai pris le 100? C'est parce que ce cake, en réalité, il est tout petit. Et justement, vu que le téléobjectif écrase les perspectives, ça va nous donner l'impression finalement bah, qu'il est plus grand, plus gros, plus goûtu. Voilà, ça c'était avec le 100. Et là, c'est avec le 24. Si j'ai un trop grand angle, je peux même pas me focaliser sur le produit parce que là, j'étais super proche en fait quand j'ai pris la photo. Donc, Ça fait une sale déformation, ça fait pas pro. Ouais. C'est caca. C'est tout caca. Du coup, on va se tenter un autre fond. Donc là, j'ai un fond ardoise, un fond bois de ouf. Un fond malachite qui défonce.
Common last suit of the day and probably the most interesting. The tastiest, I wanna say. Waffles. We're going to keep the same lighting setup, just maybe try to create a different atmosphere.
Très important de faire le casting aussi des gaufres. Pour mettre la plus belle au-dessus. Voilà, on peut peut-être faire un truc comme ça. Alors. So what's the plan? On a mis ces petites gaufrettes fourrées, c'est fourré au miel. Voilà, fourré au miel. Pour donner un peu de vie à tout ça, l'idée c'est de faire couler du miel dessus. Tout ça, ça fait genre préparer maison. Je prends une jolie cuillère parce que l'idée c'est que ben on voit aussi la cuillère dessus, comme ça accessoirise la photo.
Okay, for this type of image, you're obviously going to need a little help. You can use the tripod and the timer of your camera, but the best thing is to have someone to help you.
Pour verser le miel, je pense que ce genre de cadrage, c'est assez sympa parce qu'on voit bien.
Matilda is fortunate to have an extraordinary assistant. Well, I think it's safe to say that 90% of the work is thanks to him and to his concentration, worthy of the greatest professionals.
De toute façon, tu lèches les gaufrettes après, hein.
No secret here, you just have to be well prepared on the composition and to know perfectly how to place the spoon before making the first test with the honey, just so that you don't have to do it 100 times.
Et tu l'as mis pile au bon endroit, en vrai c'est top. Maintenant ce que tu peux faire, c'est là tu me fais une bonne grosse cuillère bien badass et tu la mets bien au milieu. Et puis comme ça, là l'idée c'est vraiment tu la verses d'un coup pour que ça fasse un gros truc, tu vois.
Grosse plaque.
C'est bon, c'est parfait, vas-y, jette. Parfait, c'est tout ce qu'on aime ça.
The result, my favorite of these three images of today. But this is how you can create food photography in DIY mode, without a lot of equipment, nor food from great restaurants.
I will add only one thing. If in your little head you think that you can't do food photography because you don't have the proper gear, you don't have this, you don't have that, we've been able to get great pictures with a bedside lamp, baking papers, a phone from years ago, and a cake dry like... Well, the waffles were okay. You'll try what we did today and you probably won't get the same results because you're missing one thing, experience. But not the camera equipment. You don't have the experience because every time you have to practice, you make excuses because you think you don't have the gear. Do you see the problem? I'll leave you here. Take a look at Matilda's Instagram if you're looking for inspiration with crazy tasty pictures. And well, you know, like the video, subscribe, all the YouTube stuff. Sorry, I'm busy today. See you, mate. Keep on creating.
Je les ai bien réussi.
Oui.
Non, c'est un... Non, il y a une canette quand même, je vais voir la canette.
Ouais. Non, mais on est assez bien.
On a pris des bouts.
Ouais. Bon, on n'a pas pris cheap food.